Senator John Kennedy, one of the most entertaining members of the United States Senate. He is, if you're not familiar with John Kennedy, he's the very folksy sounding conservative Republican who, you know, he'll be grilling a cannon. He'll say, "Now, well, listen here, you know, I," or he'll often go on cable news and he'll say, "Listen, I remember the last time a possum skinned my granddaddy. He told me," you know, and he's got all these really folksy expressions, but beneath the folksy expressions, he's always making these very perceptive points. He's very, very intelligent. He knows, he's very strategic. And kind of like we were talking about DeSantis making these deep philosophical points in a very down-to-earth way, John Kennedy does a similar kind of thing. So John Kennedy was just grilling Saule Omarova. Saule Omarova is Joe Biden's nominee for comptroller of the currency. So the person that we're going to put in charge of the currency. And the problem with Saule Omarova is that she is a communist. I'm not exaggerating. I'm not being hyperbolic. She's an actual communist. And so Senator Kennedy asked her about this.
You used to be a member of a group called the Young Communist, didn't you?
Senator, are you referring to my membership in the Youth Communist Organization while I was growing up in the Soviet Union?
I don't know. I wanted to ask you that question.
Well, Senator, I...
There was a group called the Young Communists, and you were a member. Is that right?
I'm not exactly sure which group you're referring to.
Well, the formal name of it is the Leninist Communist Young Union of the Russian Federation, and it's also known as the Leninist Komsomol of the Russian Federation, and it's commonly referred to as the Young Communists. Were you a member?
Senator, I was born and grew up in the Soviet Union.
Okay, now before we get to her bogus excuses, just look, take a masterclass lesson here in rhetoric and politics from John Kennedy. He's sitting there, he's got no paper that he's holding up, right? He's just looking. And he's playing dumb. And he goes, "Now I heard you were a member of the Young Communists. Is that right?" And so everyone who has their prejudices against conservatives, against Southerners, they're going to look at that and say, "Oh, here we go. Red Scare again. Joe McCarthy. Look at this bloviating guy. He has no idea what he's talking about. There's no group called the Young Communists." And she thinks she says, "Hold on, the young Communists? Yeah, I heard you're part of the Young Communists. Isn't that right?" Senator, I don't know what on earth you're talking about. So, okay, well, here, let me check. The actual name is the Leninist Communist. And then he goes on because he's got all the details, right? So he leads her into this trap to sort of deny the Young Communist connection. He goes, "Well, here's the official name and here's what it's known as and here's how long you were a member of it. And here is, that group." So now she's got to pivot. Now she pivots to, "Well, I grew up in the Soviet Union. I was so oppressed there. If a kid grew up in Nazi Germany, he was part of Hitler Youth. You can't blame him. All the kids were part of that. So you just like that, you can't blame this woman for being part of the Young Communists, right? Right?" Well, Kennedy keeps grilling her.
"You wrote your thesis in college at Moscow State University on, the title was Karl Marx's Economic Analysis and the Theory of Revolution in the Capital. But you won't send Senator Toomey a copy. You studied at Moscow State University, scientific communism, which is the science regarding the working class struggle and the socialist agenda. In 2019, not 30 years ago, in a Canadian documentary, you called the financial services industry, quote, a quintessential asshole industry. You wrote a paper called Systemically Significant Prices, calling for the federal government to set wages, food, gas prices. In 2020, you wrote a paper called The People's Ledger, where you said we need to abolish bank accounts and make everybody set up an account at the Fed where the federal government will have access to your data."
He goes on. He's got this woman dead to rights. And he first lets her make the condescending responds, right? You don't know what you're talking about, Senator. Then he allows her to play the victim. I grew up in the Soviet Union. I had no, and then he says, well, no, but you weren't just in the group when you were 8 or 9 years old. You went on to study scientific communism and you wrote your thesis in a defense of Karl Marx's economics. And then actually just over the last couple of years, you've been defending communist policies, including a takeover of private property by the government, takeover of private bank accounts. Just within, the problem isn't that you were a communist when you were a kid. The problem is that you are a communist now. And she, oh boy, does she look bad. Now, can the Republicans actually railroad this nominee? I'm skeptical of that. But the reason I bring it up, one, is to show you the radicalism of the Biden administration. Two, is to show you this great political tool. All of us could take a lesson in this. Manage expectations. John Kennedy, this very, very sophisticated man, walks up and he just talked like a good old boy, you know, just like a good old Uncle Bill, you know, and he, and he makes everyone underestimate him and then he clobbers them. I'm glad you like that clip. Hold up. Obviously, subscribe, ring the bell, you know, get the notifications on YouTube. But what you got to do, here's what you got to do. You got to go to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, Google Play. Wherever you get your audio podcasts, subscribe to The Michael Knowles Show. MichaelKnowlesShow. Subscribe, leave a 5-star review. We'll see you next time.